The issue of hunger in the United States is not an issue of a lack of food. There's really no reason for people to go hungry in this country.
We take for granted the fact that we have food all around us and that we can access it. All of that costs money, and if you don't have the resources, you will not be able to eat.
Several years ago, MAZON hosted a conference on hunger in Minnesota here at our congregation. We learned that in Minnesota, there is a challenging issue to schools around school lunch. Jessica Webster, one of MAZON's grantees in Minnesota, started to look into this and found out actually that the problem was quite significant.
In Minnesota, there are children who are very low income who get free lunch. And there's children that are just above the free income line and they get reduced price lunch where they're supposed to have 40 cents for lunch. What we were finding is that there were some children who didn't have the 40 cents who were showing up for lunch.
In many schools, the child would get to the end of the line in the cafeteria and the cashier would say, "You don't have enough money." Some places, what they did was they just take the lunch away and they throw it out in front of the child.
You know, some of these children, the free school meal or the reduced school meal is the only meal they may get that day. For some children, it's the healthiest meal they get of the day. It's incredible that you would rather put that food into the trash than give it to a child who is hungry.
MAZON's mission is really to advocate for change. It's about working with policymakers to come up with appropriate strategies and models to try to change the circumstances and the government response to hunger. A lot of our work's directed at Congress and the executive branch. And then we do state-based work where the people in local communities come together to make a change in their state. Well, in Minnesota, we started from a place of wanting to do work with our synagogue partners to identify what were issues in that state that they felt could be addressed through advocacy. The school lunch program came up as one of those options, and the more the congregants looked at it, the more they thought about it, it became the priority they wanted to work on.
I drafted legislation to address the issue. I thought it was an easy fix, and it was not an easy fix.
We had a bill that asked for $3.5 million of funding to make sure that the 62,000 kids who are on reduced fee school lunch in Minnesota, they wouldn't have to pay the 40 cents. And it was kind of shocking that we failed.
Anytime the state is telling local schools and local school districts what to do, especially without funds, it becomes contentious. The School Nutrition Association, which had lobbyists, staff, and a presence and a credibility at the legislature that it was difficult to overcome. This was an issue where we needed to fill hearing rooms. We needed to turn out 100 letters to legislators. We wanted people posting on social media. MAZON really stepped up. All of a sudden, we went from a very small presence to a powerful presence, and it just made a really big difference. We eventually published a report laying bare what was happening in every school in Minnesota. I mean, these things were in writing, and it just went, it went viral.
Today in Minneapolis, Governor Mark Dayton pledged to include $3.5 million in his supplemental budget request to ensure that no Minnesota students are denied access to a hot school lunch.
We started getting phone calls from legislators who wanted to carry the bill all of a sudden, wanted to be on the bill. Where's the bill? I want to be the author.
When finally the bill came to a vote in the state legislature in the House of Representatives, it won unanimously. So the bill was successful. We understood that bringing a can of food is important, but if you want to have a serious and significant impact, it is through advocacy such as this.
The experience in Minnesota is just one of a myriad of programs or activities that MAZON undertakes. But it captures so much of what our priorities are. We cannot take our eyes off of the nutrition safety net. So it's the SNAP program, it's school meals, it's Meals on Wheels for seniors, because we have policymakers that would like to dismantle it. And in Israel, where it's just an emerging issue, we feel very good about the role that we can play there.
Judaism has a deep tradition of addressing injustice in the world. And that's why we have decided that taking a position of advocacy is critical to fulfilling our responsibility to addressing issues of hunger in this country.
You know, change is incremental. You can't walk away when the going gets tough. That's when you really have to dig in and be there. But that's what you do when you're an advocate, right? So that's our job. And we do it really well.